Hi everyone, I'm Jeff Leegarden, and I'm here to help you learn how to key a SAR online through MyMASC. First and foremost, if you haven't signed up through your service center to get a MyMASC account, you do have to call our service center to do that. If you've done it, I want to walk you through the steps of how to key a ceded acreage report. First and foremost, you go to our main page, the masc.mb.ca. And right at the top in the middle, highlighted in green, is the MyMASC sign-in. Click on that, and that'll bring you to your sign-in page. Once you get to the sign-in page, you'll see where you'll have your email address and then your password. You'll click on that. Hopefully, you've already done that. When you get into it, it'll prompt you to your main page on MyMASC, which will have your active and programs. It has insurance and loans. Once you look at the insurance bold green, there's three blocks. The first one is the ceded acreage report. That's the one we want to do today. Once you click on it, it's loading and it'll bring you to your ceded acreage report main page. Starts with blue. Please complete before the deadline. As you go through it, so what we'll do is now scroll down. The first one you'll see is this questions. You have to do the questions before you submit it. So it's simple ones. Did you seed anything by helicopter? No. Did you seed any forages last spring or this fall or this spring? Hopefully no or yes. And will you seed any green feed? This is anything that will be seeded after our deadline. So we put no to all the questions. If that's the case, if it's yes, it'll prompt you to other ones. Now, simply you'll see your legal lands listed. If they're all the right ones and everything stays the same, we just start entering crops. So the first field will plus sign to a crop. And if the first one is red spring wheat, that's what we're gonna enter. So it'll be red spring wheat, the date it was seeded, which is either the date that you start or finish, but basically most times it's the date you finished, the variety and the acres. So if it's 160 acres, you just key that and you scroll down to add field and close. That's as simple as it is. The next field, if you have canola, you can just add a crop again and put it in, put the seeding date, the variety type, and the acres. If this field is only 120 acres, but there's 160, so there's 40 of something else, this is where you'll do 120 of canola, add the field and close. But before we move to the next field, and if there is 40 acres, you'll add a crop again, which is the plus sign. And if it's red spring wheat, we'll do that again. We'll put the seeding date for the red spring wheat in and your variety. Then the acres, obviously cannot exceed 170 acres. So if it's 40, we'll put 40 acres in to make a total of 160. You'll save or add and close the field. And then you can review it. So now you see you've got 160 acres, two different crops on the same legal, but everything looks right. If you only have two fields like this producer does, now you can go back to the top by clicking the button and it'll bring you to three tabs below the blue line. The first one's error and warning. So we'll click on that before you submit it and just check and see if there is any prompts. This is what we want to see everybody have, that there's no errors or warnings. Sometimes you may see that if you have exceeded last year's acres, if you had 100 last year, and you made improvements and took out some bush and you seeded 120, it will give you a warning, but you can still submit it. From there, you can go to the summary. And the summary is just gonna let you know what your total acres of each crop type that you've done are. So you can click on that and review it. It'll show you obviously your 200 acres of red spring wheat, which is on two fields, and 120 of canola. If you made a mistake, this is where you can go back to your fields and check it out. It can list your acres per crop, like we're seeing right now with the two fields of red spring wheat and the one of canola. If everything looks good, you now can go back up to the top one more time and review and submit This is when you feel everything's done right, and this is the final step. So now you'd hit the review and submit. It'll summarize it one more time as an overview. It'll let you know this producer had hail insurance. It lets you know about that. And as you keep scrolling down, if everything looks good, you will see the button to agree to the terms and declaration. And then it's the ceded acreage report submit button right at the bottom. And sometimes it may take a little bit of time once it's done, but now you're able to see your documents and record the PDFs. If you have other questions about how to key anything, there will be other videos online, whether it is how to key a forage establishment, we'll have one of that, how to key a excess moisture claim, adding or deleting land, or a reseed. So please check the YouTube video channel for any other questions you have, and we hope that works for you. Have a great day.